Speaker, last week the industry minister unveiled yet another Conservative Party attack ad. This Republican-style negative attack ad not only failed to tell Canadians the truth, it even broke Canada's copyright laws. The industry minister is allowing his party to break the same copyright act that he himself is responsible for. Why won't the minister stand up and simply demand that the Conservative Party obey the law?
The Honourable Minister of Industry.
Speaker, I welcome my honourable friend lately to the law of copyright. I wish him well. In fairness, Mr. Speaker, he must admit the song For the Love of Money does bring to mind the Liberal Party. This is the party of big spending proposals of $98 billion over 4 years. This is the party of deficits, Mr. Speaker, proposing a deficit to Canadians of $62 billion. A loud group, Mr. Speaker, but also not the party of answers because they don't have an explanation of where the money is going to come from.
King's hands.
Mr. Speaker, so much for accountability. The best defense that the industry minister has come up with is that the negative attack ad wasn't really an ad. By failing to get permission from before releasing the attack ad, the Conservative Party broke the law. Is this simply another case of the Conservative Party believing that it operates above the Canadian law?
The Honourable Minister of Industry.
Talking about budget time, that always brings out the very worst in the Liberals. This is the party of big spending. It's inexplicable, but Mr. Speaker, it's been said before in this House, Mr. Speaker, and I quote, the spenders in the Liberal Party are revving up their engines again. Nothing starts a feeding frenzy more than the smell of cash around Liberal backbenches. The member from King Hans.